You know that I've been in love with optics that are focus-free for some time now, especially for surveillance work or for quick deployment when you're on the trail. When you don't have time to focus in on the target because the target happens to be moving, such is the case for deer, foxes, and all other animals on the trails, especially in Northern Virginia. By the time that you get your binoculars out from your chest harness or up from your neck strap and get the subject into focus, subject is gone. Hence, autofocus or fixed focus. So that has been my latest kick, and in that vein, I purchased the Bushnell Sport Optics Spectator Sport in 10x50. And I thought that I would love this unit. Now, I'm not going to give away my review, so let's go through this piece by piece. What came in the box? Well, we have your case here. It's a neoprene case, very thin material, goes around your shoulders, Velcro, very thin. It was a nice addition to an inexpensive unit. I'll take it, but it is not a quality that is anything to write home about. In the box also came our very necessary microfiber cleaning cloth, our Bushnell Spectator Sport Series instruction manual. Now that's funny. If you need an instruction manual for a focus-free set of binoculars, something's wrong. But anyway, it's something that they put in the box, and it's something that I will keep in the box, never to have read it myself. But we always look at the box for what they tell us about the attributes of our binoculars. So we see Bushnell, nice picture. Box is not bad. It's got a lot of writing on it. But let's focus in on these. Permafocus, focus-free technology. Customizable design. And water resistance. 10x50, 50mm objective lens, 10 magnification. And for those of you that are new to binoculars and you have yet to become an optic freak like me and many of the subscribers to this channel, when we say 50mm objective lens, we're talking about from here to here as far as the lens is concerned, the front lens. The lens that you are looking through that are closest to your eyes, those are the ocular lens. All right, it said something about customizable. What do you mean by that? Well, yeah. This is what they mean by that. It's a black, red, blue little logo imprinted plastic pieces that go right there where these white pieces are currently. That's the customizable. You saw me take the objective lens cover off. I like it when manufacturers give us these soft covers, not bad. I wish that these could be or were attached to the body. In that way, I wouldn't be able to lose it as much as I do out on the trail, but I'll take it. These soft covers generally go on based on friction, and they don't crack over time unless you put them into freezing weather facing the harsh elements of the outside world. They're soft, pliable. Silicone, more than likely. Not bad. On the ocular lens side, we've got an equally soft, pliable cover. It does its job. These little nooks are what you place the strap through. You get a nice strap with this unit. It's cushioned, got the Bushnell name on it. Fairly thick, wide, to stay around your neck and give you some level of comfort. A little bit of cushion there. Pretty rudimentary so far. Now let's talk about the actual unit. Absolutely nothing to do with this unit other than put it up to your face, your eyeballs, look through, and get your sight picture. There are no knobs. No diopter knob here. No focus wheel here. And I like that. What I don't like about this unit, and I have to forgive them because it is a 50 millimeter objective lens on this, is the weight. This is a very weighty unit, I gotta tell you. You know it's around your neck when you're on the trail. Absolutely, there's no hiding it. I took this out on two trips so far, and I knew that I had a pair of binoculars, both in my bag over there and around my neck when I had it around my neck going up and down the trail. What is the weight of this unit? Let's see if this box helps us out any. Right there. 31 ounces. That's not a joke, people. It's not a joke. Okay, this is the back of the box. Let's go through what it says. Focus free, customizable, water resistance, multi-coated optics. Down here, field of view, 341 feet. Eye relief, 15 millimeters. Why is that important to me? Because I wear glasses, people. I need at least 15 millimeter eye relief in order to use binoculars comfortably with my eyeglasses on. Exit pupil, 5.0 millimeters. Now that is a nice size exit pupil for sure. Length, 6.5 inches. This is the length, 6.5 inches, here to here. When we say exit pupil of 5.0 millimeters, we're talking about the ocular lens. Exit pupil is right here, 5 millimeters across this way, okay? When we're talking about eye relief of 15 millimeters. That means that in its lowest position, which this is right now, you've got 15 millimeters to play with from the top of the lens to your cornea for optimal vision through these binoculars. I like to, and I made a video on the importance of eye relief. If you haven't watched that video, watch it. It's on my playlist of all videos that deal with binoculars and optics. I go into exactly why eye relief, greater eye relief, is necessary. I'll give you a hint. If you're wearing goggles of any sort to protect your eyes from either smoke or fragmentation of any kind, or insects, if you've got those around, and you happen to be mountain biking or something else, you need to have a longer eye relief to allow you to use the binoculars while you're wearing said goggles, right? So, I took this out to the trail several times, twice. Did I like it? Yeah, I really didn't like the weight, though. And here's the other thing I didn't like. The quality of the optics. Things weren't exactly as sharp as I am used to. Now, Bose, these optics cost you how much? Well, these Bushnells are going for about $100. And, well, what can you expect for $100, Bose? Well, funny you should ask. These on sale were also $100. Bose, you're comparing apples with oranges. That's a Fujinon Mariner unit, marine unit, in 7x50. And it's got fixed focus. Yeah. I got all that. I'm talking about the quality of the optics. I want sharp vision, people. Sharp. These are wearing some binos up in here. If you don't know what the binos are, I made another video on what these are, right? They keep out all of the ambient light from your eye area so as to give you an ability to see without a bunch of glare hitting off the ocular lens. Now, yes, those that know this unit understand immediately this is a Fujinon. This is not focus free. It's what we know as independent focus. What does that mean, Bose? Well, that means that each of these eyepieces are focused individually just one time for one user. First, focus the right eyepiece, then the left eyepiece, and you don't have to focus it at all forever more. That's called independent focus. Getting back to the quality of the optics, though. These Fujinons retail for I don't know how much, but I can pick these up on sale on Amazon and other venues for about $100. Which one do I prefer to take with me on the trail if I am looking for a unit that's about 6 or 7 inches tall and has some heft to it? These Fujinons also have some heft to it based on the size of the unit. But which one would I take based on the quality of the view? These, not these. Now, that isn't to say that this is fixed autofocus, permanent focus. That means that when I look through it, I have no adjustments to make. When my wife looks through it, no adjustments to make. Daughter, no adjustments to make. This, remember I told you, it's independent focus. Each person that you give this to has got to go through that process of focusing the right, focusing the left, and then being able to have permanent fixed focus on objects that are 75 feet in front of you. With these, you can give them to anybody. They don't need to do a thing. Nothing. Other than maybe, what we haven't talked about yet, adjust the eye cups. And speaking about eye cups, that's what these are. That's it. No detents, no indents, just a straight smooth to the top, to the bottom. And it's not much that we're talking about as far as distance is concerned, as you can see. Once up though, fair amount of pressure is required to tap them down. Nobody's going to put these eye cups against their forehead or their eye sockets with that much pressure. So, build quality is good on this unit, I must say. It does, like I said, 31 ounces, no joke, but it does have good build quality. Armor, top to bottom. Nice. Nice tactile feel here with these little jimping, if you want to call it that. Soft, pliable, as you can see here. I'm going to put my nail in. It makes a little indent, pops right out. So easy to carry like this. Very easy, actually. But quality of the optics leaves something to be desired. I'll keep these in my collection, maybe as a backup unit to somebody that comes along with us on a hike or on a hunt or on, you know, one of my events that I, sporting events that I go to. I'll take it along with me. But is it my first choice? No. I'd much rather take this. And if I'm looking for a smaller unit, I would much rather take the other permanent focus unit that I showed you all in the video from last week. If you haven't seen my Tasco video on the Tasco fixed focus units, watch that video. Those units, optic-wise, those Tascos, blow these away. So there you have it. I'm still working on these Bressers over here, and I'll get to these when I get to these, maybe today as my next video of the day. But that is my review of the Bushnells. Do I like them? Yes. Do I love them? No. I think that you can get better for your money, and if one binocular unit is what you are going to purchase for sporting events and otherwise, I'll have you take a look at the Tascos. And if you don't care about permanent focus and can deal with fixed independent focus, these Fujinon Mariners. There you have it. I'm Attorney Bose. I am not an expert. Subscribe to the channel if you want to have fun with optics and you're an optic freak like me.